Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. This is my first video based on Internet of Things. Here I'll be discussing about introduction to IoT. Let us start this session with first agenda, that is IoT in general. See, IoT is Internet of Things. So in IoT, we will be interfacing things with internet. See, internet is kind of computer network that you can say, where there will be servers and there will be computers. So computers will be accessing data from server with the use of internet. Let me explain you first what is internet, and then I'll give you some examples of IoT. So here, when you talk about internet, then on internet we are connected with many devices like tablet, we are connected with mobile phones, we are connected with computers. See, these are the devices that is there with users, and users are using services from internet with the use of servers. So with the use of servers, there can be varieties of applications. Like you can have email service application, you can have banking application, you can have music application, you can have video application, you can have shopping application, right? So here on server, these are the applications which is available with different companies. And users with the use of these devices can use these services with the use of internet. But in IoT, we are having more varieties of applications. Here, what we will be doing is, we will be using some devices. Those devices will be sensing some data. That data will be uploaded on the internet. And from internet, any user can access those data to optimize any application. Let me give you some examples. Like here, I'll be considering first example for smartwatch in things. So in smartwatch, you'll be observing different data like heart rate, how many steps are there per day, how much calorie that is burnt per day, right? All those data in real time can be uploaded on internet. And that user can have understanding related what has to be the actual data, so that they can optimize their performance in their daily life. Let me take some more examples. Like here now I'll be taking one example of car. So in car, if you add some sensors, then you can monitor what is the speed of car, you can monitor what is the location of car, you can monitor how much fuel is there with given car. So without going inside car, you can have all those datas with the use of IoT, where these sensors will be measuring all this data, and that is getting uploaded on the internet, so user can access those data from anywhere. Let me take few more examples. Like here, we are having one factory. So with factory, there can be varieties of operations. Like there can be vigilance control, we need to have fault detection, we can have robotics as well. So all this data that can be uploaded on the internet with the use of things, where with this IoT application, we can optimize performance of factory. Now, I'll be considering one more example. So here, I'll be taking example of smart home. So in smart home, we can have television, we can have fridge, we can have security system. So all this data of devices can be uploaded on the internet, and from internet, user can access those information. Like if somebody is staying over here in India, and if one is having home at Canada, then that person can see what is happening with the devices which are there inside home. Like person can see security cameras from anywhere, person can see what is the current condition of fridge, TV and many other devices, right? Now I'm going to explain you importance of IoT. So here what I'll do is, I'll be considering relative scenario. So without IoT, let me consider one scenario where I'll be considering one farm. So here without IoT, we are having one farm, and in that we are having so many resources with this given farm without IoT, right? And control will be manual control without IoT. So as per manual control, we need to have more resources. It consumes more time without IoT, as well as there will be decrease in farm yield. Now, to optimize our resources, we can use IoT. Internet of Things, in which we can optimize many parameters. Let me show you a scenario in which we will be having same farm with the use of IoT. So in that, if you have sensor which monitors soil moisture, right, then that soil moisture that could be connected with Wi-Fi, and Wi-Fi will be giving that data to internet. From internet, user can access that data from anywhere, right? Here, see, once that data that is provided to internet, we can control many things. Like, as if moisture is less with the given soil, then we can turn on the valve by which we can control moisture of given soil, right? Here we can have historical data as well. So see, here person does not need to go to farm to control all those things. There is no need of manual control. With the use of smart device, directly one can control all the parameters which is there with given farm. So here you will be saving some resources, right? In manual control, you will be wasting water, you will be wasting time as well. Here you will be saving time, you will be increasing farm yield, and you will be saving cost as well. The reason is, these IoT sensors and IoT devices are not that costly, right? Now I'll be going to explain you few definitions of IoT. See, IoT is Internet of Things, where we interface things with internet, and by which we will be optimizing resources, right? We will be saving time for humans. But still, there are few definitions that I would like to explain you over here. So first definition that states, IoT is the network of physical objects or things, right? So here IoT is network of objects. So it is not like you are controlling one device. There is a network of so many devices. Like, you will be having data of what is happening in Gujarat and what is happening in Maharashtra, and based on location, what is the best suitable solution for given problem, that one can identify over here, right? So here there will be network of objects, and that is what we are having with the use of embedded devices, right? And that we can have it with the use of electronics, software, sensors, and we are connecting all together on internet, which will enables these objects to collect and exchange the data. Let me show you some more definitions. IoT allows objects to be sensed and controlled remotely across existing network infrastructure, by which it will be creating more opportunities for more direct integration in between the physical world and computer-based system. And it will be resulting in terms of improved efficiency, in terms of accuracy, and in terms of economic benefit. So here our agenda is to improve efficiency of objects, right? So with the use of Internet of Things, we can control many things from anywhere, right? So it is not necessary like you should be there at that location. From anywhere you can control all those things with the use of IoT. There are a few more definitions. Like, you see, things in IoT sense can refer to a wide variety of devices, such as heart monitoring implants, biochip transponders on farm animals, electric can in coastal waters, automobile with built-in sensors, DNA analysis devices for environmental food and pathogen monitoring, or field operation devices that exist fire fighters in search and rescue operations. So these are the varieties of application that is listed, by which you can understand like how important IoT is in current world, right? The reason is, you can monitor many things from anywhere. If you talk about another definition, then it states that devices collect useful data with the help of various existing technologies and then autonomously flows the data between other devices, right? So relative comparison is also available in front of you, and that comparison can also be optimized with the use of algorithms, right? In short, you can have best possible solution to any problem with the use of IoT devices. Now I'm going to explain you ABCD of IoT. So A stands for applications. So in applications, you can have smart home, you can have some wearables like smart watch, you can have smart cities, even you can have smart retail, right? So there are many applications available on IoT devices. B stands for big data analytics. So here, see, there will be so many users. So many IoT devices will be there. So you'll be having large data, and based on data, one can do anything, right? You can have relative comparison, you can have algorithm on data, and based on data, one can optimize the resources. When we talk about C, then that is connectivity and communication. So as I have told you, many devices are there. Those are connected as per internet, and based on that connection, optimization is possible, right? Like you can observe here, we are having one gateway. Many devices are there. Those are connected with internet, and on internet, there can be varieties of algorithms by which base suitable solutions that can be provided to user over here. And when we talk about D, then that is devices that are smart over here, right? Like you can talk about mobile phones, smartwatch, smart devices are there, like smart sunglasses, right? There are many applications available. So these devices are getting smarter and smarter because of IoT. Why? The reason is, with the use of sensors, we are sending those data on internet, and from internet we can access practical situation in best possible manner, right? Now I'll be going to discuss about history of IoT. So that was initiated way back in 1982s, where Carnegie Mellon researchers connect a vending machine to internet to remotely check the cold sodas. So this is soda machine, and that was been controlled remotely in 1982. Then in 1990s, first toaster was operated over the internet. Then in 1999, Internet of Things was coined by Kevin Austin in a presentation to Procter and Gamble in 1999, right? Then in 2000, LG have introduced first smart fridge. Then in 2004, smartwatch was introduced. In 2007, Apple smart iPhone and wearable Fitbit was released. In 2009, Google have started testing self-driven cars. In 2011, smart TV was introduced. In 2013, Google Lens was released. There were many applications, right? In 2014, Echo causes a surge in smart home market. So likewise, there are so many applications that is getting upgraded with respect to time. Right now in 2023, IoT is in huge demand, and many people are accessing Internet of Things devices by which they are optimizing their life, they are enjoying their journey in this world. I hope you are getting all those things related IoT in introduction. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.